crucial bye week, the Texas Longhorns taking on the 19th ranked team in the land, the Oregon State Beavers.
So it's one of those creeper games. Oh, and QB?
Line gets set, first down. Here's the handoff. Shakes off the defender. And he does a really nice job finding open space and making a good gain before the stop is made. They can really be aggressive after that last play. It's second and three. Off the play fake. Throws to the wideout. Finds a man on the left. He is run out of bounds, but not before turning in a big pickup and moving the sticks for a first down.
That's a nice looking catch on that play, and I know Texas is known for DBs, and they're known for having really good running backs. Not a lot of great receivers over the years. I'll tell you what, though, this guy has really showed up in this game. He's making plays, and I know they want to continue to build a legacy at this position here in this program.
It's interesting, they're going to play running back. They say you've had a lot of running backs like Ricky Williams and stuff, but no wide receivers.
He's looking to throw.
And then they say we have wide receivers like Ricky Williams and no running back.
Oftentimes in college football, the best offenses are the ones that can create explosive plays just like you saw right there. They're top 10 in the nation in points per game because they don't have to drive the field. They've got dudes scattered all over this offense that can take it the distance on any given play.
Mm-hmm. Yes, we do, sir.
The Longhorns sending the offense back onto the field. And David Howell, they would love to stick it in the end zone one more time after that last drive.
And once you get the defense on their heels and you back them off a little bit, you get a little bit of rhythm, it's really hard to stop, Jesse, and they're going to try to do it again right here.
And if you're this play caller, you're loving what's happening right now because everything you dialed up on that last drive ended up working out. You're just looking at your play sheet.
There
you
go.
Everything you're picking is working. Let's see if they can pull it off again here.
And I don't care if I get it by 2, by 20, by 30, by 40. I just want to get the first down, understanding the situation, understanding where the sticks are. Doesn't have to be sexy, but I got to make sure I get to that stick, get to the first down mark.
Hold it, open.
Just an obvious holding call there, and one that just kills an offense's momentum. Looking for a productive play on first down. They want to throw it. Blasted as he lets it go. Hit hard as he released the ball. First down pass, and it never had a chance. Final play of the quarter coming. The play action fake.
No, that's not where I wanted to go with it.
They get him on the ground, and with that, we'll head to the second quarter. Guys, it is Texas who holds the lead. And we've come to the end of the first as we take a moment to check out the stats so far. Now to see if these guys can get back in the game as we open the second quarter. A third down play to get the quarter started. Looking downfield, and he needs a bunch.
There we go, baby.
And he was loose and in the open field and on his way. A tremendous pickup on that one. The Longhorns are on the move. He wants to throw it again. Pulls it in. It's Randall. They make the stop after the catch and still some work to do to pick up that first down. A little bit more to go after that last completion. They'll try to pick it up on second down.
They missed the kick.
They'll run it from the gun.
Ooh.
That's what you expect from a senior. Don't give them any extra yards. Great tackle there. Play number 7 on this drive. It'll be 3rd and 2. They'll try to move the chains on the ground. They'll move the chains. Good execution on third down. They've got it at the 41. The Longhorns will snap it on first and 10. Use the play fake. Now to throw. Looking to the big tight end. And you just don't expect your junior quarterback to get fooled and to throw it into double coverage like that. The emotions and energy figure to be high all day, guys, because of what's at stake this late in the season. Really a must-win for both teams.
Yeah, these are the ones that get your blood moving, Reese. You get jacked up, man. We don't have to say anything in the locker room, give these big speeches. You know what's at stake, Jesse. You're ready to rock and roll. This is when you prove you're the big dog.
Which is pretty cool, too, because it's been a long season. These teams, obviously, are both physically and mentally tired. But you're right. For this kind of game,
right through his
this
hands.
Is the one you circled at the start of the year. You knew that this was going to matter. There was going to be a lot on the line. Now, it's time to go out and prove you're the better team.
On second down, he'll try to make the connection this time. He's got him this time. And he's brought down after a nice game. The Longhorns want to move quickly. Looking to pass inside the red zone. Tip ball put it up for Grams, and I thought he had it, but somehow it slithered through his fingers. After the quarterback and receiver failed to hook up, they'll try it again on second down. Wide receiver shows motion. They're bringing heat.
Dude, there's no way. I threw that way before. That's okay. Stupid.
Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. The receivers often will run their route based on a side adjustment. They'll start this drive with a pass.
He didn't catch it.
He had it right down the middle and he flat dropped it. After the incompletion, it's second down. He's looking to throw. Unloads to the wideout. Catch in the middle. It's Avery. Really nice pickup there as they have it out to the 44 with a first down. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Finds his big tight end. And he's brought down, but a flag is also
holding.
Down.
Holding.
That penalty moves the ball back 10 yards. We'll replay the down. Well, that's going to make it a little tougher. It's first and 20. Plus the pass. Throws to the wideout. And they won't make the connection going for the big play. Second and 10 after the previous play.
And the offensive coordinator here is really trying to stay aggressive and take a shot. Obviously, the offense couldn't click on that one.
There you go, Washington.
Find some space. Defense on skates that time. They finally drag him down at the 42. A first and 10 for this offense. He's looking to throw it. And it's incomplete. If you're going to take a hit like that, you might as well hang on to the ball. After the misfire, now on second down. He's looking to throw. Deep shot for the end zone. And good coverage there to knock it away and deny the score. They line up and it is a long
I expect
way
my
to
guys to make that
here.
Play.
On third and long, try to convert through the air.
He just dropped it, man.
Right through his hands and
Jesus.
Down after the
that's not okay, man.
First down for this offense. Trying to start the drive with a pass. Unleashes one deep. And this will be incomplete. A big hit there forces second down. Time dwindling away as they try to put points
on the board catch the ball
right
Sunday.
The right back to the air on second and 10. This time it's complete. Put it right on him. Sweet play. Good pickup. And they'll move the chains with the first down. They'll use a timeout right before halftime. Maybe time for one or two more plays. Quarterback reacting to what the D is showing. He's going to pass. Looking down the middle. Got it. Quick timeout call by the offense after the play. Timeout. Line gets set, first down. Use the play fake, now to throw. Not in lockstep there with
the receiver. Dude, catch the damn ball.
This offense has a second down plan.
Things I want to do when I come into a game is I'm going to go, where do I have the advantage? Where are my guys better than yours? And maybe they feel good about their matchup out wide. Some of those wide receivers making some of these big plays down the field. This is a good sign for this offense.
They just changed the dynamic of this possession in a heartbeat, and now it's first and 10 from inside the red zone. He wants to throw. That's reeled in. It's Washington. That completion gets them inside the 10, and the defense is running out of room to defend. Going to work on second down in the red zone, and still some ground to cover to pick up that first down. They'll run it to the right side. They bring him down, and he's going to lose a yard on
wrong
that
one. Button again.
Well, we know this defense is one that plays with a lot of pride, right? Part of that is their ability to stop and run. They're a top 25 unit in the nation when it comes to stopping the rush. And that
touchdown, Texas! Reeled it in and just made the house call.
Thank you.
They want to finish the season strong, and man, are they doing that here in this Week 11 performance.
One of the reasons this offense is so exciting to watch, they've got guys that are dangerous after the catch. And if this quarterback gets through his progression, Dave, and hits you in stride, these guys will take it to the house.
Man, it's your job to do the rest, right? You hit me in stride where I don't have to stop running. I don't have to break down. It makes it...
And here comes the Texas offense back on the field. Wide receiver now comes in motion. Leaves it with the back.
That's not good.
Now with they had in mind to start this drive, here comes second and 13. From his end zone, trying to loosen up this knee. Quick strike complete.
Nice, Ryan.
He's close to the first down, but they're going to mark him just a little short.
After giving up a few extra yards after a hitch throw, I wonder if this defense is going to want to give this guy this much access moving forward. They might be thinking about more press coverage or playing some zone coverage where the corner's right up on
him. Got his man downfield. He'll make a play on third down. He's got enough for the first
and did it again.
At the 32.
Did it again.
And the Longhorns come to the line with a new set of downs. The give. He's knocked
down
to the
back.
Down,
man.
Well, there's a statement by the defensive line. First down play, expecting run, and they just dominated up front. Beat their one-on-ones and forced a tackle for a loss.
On second down, he'll fire. Throws for the tight end. And that one's incomplete.
What the f- like, how do why do they keep going through their hands? That's what's annoying.
On third down, he drops the throw.
Oh, dropped right in coverage. My bad, obviously. That's fucking annoying.
And the senior just took that one up.
Shut up.
So now the Longhorns take over and they'll send out the offense. Boy, they hope this next drive is more productive after throwing a pick last time, Jesse.
Yeah, and the coaches did a good job on the sideline there, just talking to the young quarterback and making sure he's able to turn the page, calm him down, to go out and refocus this drive.
Yeah, and some people do that better than others, but you got to show some trust in him, maybe get the ground game going, help around him a little bit with this system.
He wants to take the top off.
And how dude, about you're like a foot taller than that guy.
Forcing the incomplete pass. After the quarterback and receiver failed to hook up, they'll try it again on second down. Fires to the wideout. Already find a hole in that secondary. And he'll go out of bounds, and this aerial attack just continues to carve this defense into tiny slices. They'll keep it on the ground.
Mm.
A solid pickup there.
Good job not getting stuck in the back.
It's a point in the game, I think, as a coaching staff, where you really challenge your offensive line to go win the football game, right? You've got to lead late. We're going to run the football. And the defense and everybody in the stadium knows that's what's going to happen. Can we run the ball down their throats and impose our will? That's what this offense right now is trying to do.
Third down play from the gun. Throws to the back. And it's intercepted, maybe breathing a little life into this team. Looking for more room. And he was trying to chart a course on that pick for a pick six, but he'll be stopped at the 31.
I'm just trying to get it in there. Let's go. No sense of urgency, not really caring at all.
Here comes the Texas offense. That last drive was promising for a while, but you just can't mess it up at the end with the pick, Jesse.
No, you got to be able to finish drives.
He uncorks one deep. And the ball is caught. He's inside the 35. And the Longhorns are in the hurry up.
What a beautiful throw and catch on this play. And I love the job the receiver did tracking the ball in the air. Nice job of locating the throw and then hauling it in.
That is exactly what you're looking for when you talk explosive plays. The defense finally able to make the stop. Moving the running back, trying to get the D to tip its hand. He caught it! And he won't be able to push his way in. He stopped at the one. Second and goal for the offense. We have a warning at the 2-minute warning, a one possession game as this offense tries to hold on. If they can move that thing 1 yard here, that'll probably wrap this bit. And he takes it in for the score.
Wrap it up, baby. Let's go. You
want
to try to fight
offense
to the end? We can do that.
Out of the shotgun, they go to the ground. Really nice stop there from this senior leader. Timeout called by the defense. 23 seconds left on the clock.
I never know if it's grammatically correct to say a team is being out physical. You hear it a lot in football, though. That's happening in this game. They are just not getting the push they need all game long up front to have any success when they decide to run.
Timeout. How was that? We got 9 yards. 19 ticks remaining.
Smart offense. I love it, man. Make them use that timeout. Run the football. I can run the football and let that clock now tick inside of a minute. I'm in great situation to win this football game. Just be smart and keep that thing running.
The defense will use a timeout here. There are 16 seconds left to play.
Sure, we'll just end it.
I'll say, watching this offense this year, one of the things you have to be really happy about is their ability to move the sticks. This is one of the top 25.
I'm very happy about our ability to move the
sticks. Getting first downs, that running back was one of the biggest reasons. He is a weapon.
It came down to the final quarter, clutch plays, guys deliver,
horrible game,
and they get the close win.
Yeah, Reese, big-time players make big plays in big games, and that's what happened in this circumstance. As a coaching staff, David,
two
you,
picks,
love,
that's not
you
okay.
Know that you have confidence in your guys to go out and be able to execute when it matters the most.
Correct, and you don't know until the games, right? You don't know when those moments present themselves. How are they going to handle it? Great job handling the close game.
Well, at least we won. That's all that's important, but
that's going to do it for us. For Jesse Palmer, we're going to do better.
As always,
this has been another presentation of EA Sports.